according to the law of mass conservation.
Of conservation of energy. So we start to calculate the mass of the reactant after the balancing. 2 multiplied by 24 plus 2 multiplied by 16 will give us 8 grams. And for the product, 2, 24 plus 16 equals 80 grams.
Stoichiometry, it is a chemical calculation, quantitative chemistry. It's talking about the how the mass of the reactant equal the mass of the product. Okay? Right. We want to connect between mass, we want to connect between the volume and number of atoms or molecules. Atoms, ions. Again, stoichiometry, it is a quantitative chemistry, how which the mass of the reactant equal the mass of the product. Then we are to connect between the mass, volume, and the molecule. Return back to the structure of the matter. We find the matter consists of small building units called the molecules, and the molecules consist of the atoms. One of the scientists starts to connect between the mass, volume, and the molecule. He said we are going to talk about this word, molecules. And we start taking the first source of it, mole. So we'll find the mole can connect between the mass and the molecules or atoms and the volume.
But return back to the preparatory stage and start to talk about the definition of the mole.
Definition of the mole, it is the molecular mass represented in gram. Let's take an example. When I ask you to take or to bring the molecular mass of the sodium hydroxide, so the sodium equals 23, oxygen equals 16, the hydrogen equals 1, so it's equal 40 grams.
We're talking about the mass number of the element, the mass number of the element. So to connect between the mass, the volume, and the molecule or the atom, we are going to talk about the mole. What's meant by the mole? Molecular mass represented in the gram. Molecular mass represented in the gram. Time. From where I can find or detect from this values, or from where I can detect that its the relationship is correct.
If I'm taking a different example of nitrogen, oxygen, or methane gas, so I want to present this three samples of the gases according to the mass, according to the volume, and according to the molecules or number of atoms, molecules, maybe atoms, maybe ions, we'll find when we calculate the mass of the nitrogen gas, it will be molecular mass 2 multiplied 14 equal 28 gram. And when we calculate the mass of the oxygen, it will be 2 multiplied 16 equal 32 gram. And the mass of the methane gas, 14 or 12 for the carbon, plus 4 multiplied 1 equal 16 gram. So when we connect between the molar mass of each one, mole represented from three different substances according to the mass, it will be equal to the same number? No, they are different in masses. The one mole from the nitrogen 28 gram, the one mole from the oxygen 32 gram, the one mole from the methane gas is 16 gram. But if we want to present it according to the volume, All of these conditions according to STP. What's meant by STP? Standard, temperature, and pressure. It means what? It means the temperature of the room temperature, 25 degrees Celsius, and the atmospheric pressure, 1 atmospheric pressure, or 76 centimeter mercury. If we represent the volume of the three gases according to the two STP, we'll find the volume, it will be 22.4 liter. For the oxygen, 22.4 liter. For the methane gas, 22.4 liter. Fine. According to the molecule, if we represent it according to the molecule, we'll find the scientist, he said that the mole, it's called amount of Avogadro. Avogadro said that each element or each substance or molecule or compound is contained according to the STP, a fixed number of molecules, atoms, or ions. It is the same idea. So we'll find it will be 6.02 times 10 bar 23 molecule, atom, or ion according to the problem. 6.02 times 10 bar 23. Enter. According to this, we'll find 6.02 times 10 bar 23. We can collect all of this relationship in this magic triangle. According to the American method, we'll find a thing, it's called the Iceland, Moore Iceland. It's not good, I think. So I'm going to talk about the traditional method, it's talking about the magic triangle. To collect all of this relationship, magic triangle consists of the three sections. The related section for of the three is called B mole. In each one, we are gonna to calculate the number of moles. Number of moles. Number of moles. If we calculate the number of moles according to the mass, it will be mass of substance according to the mass of one mole, it will be molar mass. All of this in a gram. What's meant by the molar mass? Mass of one mole. Top. If you want to calculate the number of moles according to the volume, it will be the volume of substance divided the volume of one mole, it is a fixed number, as we said, 22.4 liter. If you want to calculate it according to number of atoms, ions, molecules, it will be the same. The number of atoms, molecule, atoms, ions, divided the number of molecule, ion, atoms that found in one mole, it's Avogadro's number, 6.02 times 10 power 23. Atom, ion, or a molecule. We want to connect between the mass, volume, and the number of molecules according to the mole. They will find a great difference since the volume is related to the are calculated according to the letter, and we will find the mass is calculated by the gram machine. Okay, the volume it's are applied on the case of the gases all the time, and we'll find it to deal with the solid substance. We'll find maybe the volume related to the liquid substance, but the mass may be taking the liquid substance or a different substance. The volume of this substance, but according to the STP, all the substances contain the same volume. Fixed standard volume, 22.4 liter. We are going to talking about the problems. It is the analysis for the, we'll find the one from the concept is talking about the analysis. And the unit of each one, we'll find the message related to the grams. and we'll find the ions, its atoms or ions or molecule, and we'll find the volume, it's related to the letters. So in our planning, we are going to talk about the problems. We connect firstly between the mole and the mass of the substance. Then in another problem, we are going to connect between the volume and the number of moles. Then we are going to talk, connect between the number of atoms, molecules, ions, then the mole. Then we are going to connect between the two different type of the problems. We will make between the mass and the volume, between the volume and the number of atoms. Then we are going to talk about the stoichiometry and the chemical equations. Then we're talking about the limiting reactant and the practical yield, our percentage yield. This is talking about the first problem, it's a simple one. Calculate the mass of 0.5 mole of sodium hydroxide. Na equal 23, O equal 16, and we find the hydrogen equal 1. We are going to talk about solving this problem by two different ways. The first one according to that rule, and another one we are going to talk about it according to the scissor method. Okay? We want connected to calculate the mass of the substance, mass according to the number of moles. So firstly we return back to the first triangle. Mass of the substance, we need the mass of the substance. So firstly we write the root number of moles equal mass of substance divided the molar mass. Very easy, that's simple. We'll find the number of moles is 0.5 mole equal mass of the substance is unknown. The molar mass, it will be calculated. The mass of the substance will be calculated. So we'll find the Na, it will be 23 plus an oxygen 16 and the hydrogen is equal to 1. So we'll find the mass of the substance, mass of substance equal 0.5 multiplied 40 equal 20 gram. First way. Okay? Then we are going to talk about the scissor. In this simple idea, we'll find the scissor, it will be the hard method. But after we connect with the scissor, we'll find it the easy problem and it will solve a lot of problems according to the stoichiometry. Firstly, according to the scissor, we're making the table like this. In this table, we deal with the substance is called the sodium hydroxide. We will write it in this place. And under it, in the first cell, we'll find mole. Then return back to the problem. We want to deal with the sodium hydroxide according to the mass. So first cell, we'll write the mass and the mass by gram. And 0.5 mole, another cell will find the mole. Start to making the relationship, yes. Mole in front of mole from the sodium hydroxide, it is one. Since the sodium hydroxide is not entered the chemical reaction, there is no balancing, it is still what's the same. Mole in front of the mole is one. Mole change it to mass of the sodium hydroxide. Mole and the molar mass. Sodium hydroxide is 23 plus the oxygen equals 16 and the hydrogen equal 1. Return back to the problem. We're finding the problem 0.58 mole. Under it, 0.5. Cross multiplication, you'll find the answer. This method is tidy since it helps you to determine what is the unit of the thing it will be out. The unit of the thing it will be out will be the gram, since we calculate what? The mass of the substance. You can copy the two methods and you can take in the photo since we are cleaning the board, inshallah.
You see that? Okay.
Do you have a problem or what? Example for you, you start to calculate it. According to the scissors, huh? Yes? Okay. In the scissor method, we will find the relationship. The relationship according to the problem, calculate the mass. So we find the mass according to 0.5 moles, number of moles. So in the first one, we calculate according to the standard. We find the standard of us is the mole. Mole, in the front of the mass, you calculate the molecular mass. So the molecular mass from the sodium hydroxide, 23 plus 16 plus 1, 5. Mole, in the front of mole of the sodium hydroxide, there is no difference, it's the same. Okay, we will find the one of the sodium peroxide to contain the molecular mass. If we have 0.5 mole, what is the mass it will be? It will be 20 grams. Okay. Inshallah, we are going to talk about the another problem. What is the firstly you write it, you cap it, then you calculate it, then there is a return to discuss about it. Find the mass out the number of mole in 46 grams of carbon dioxide gas. Carbon equal 24, carbon equal 12, oxygen equal 16. Thank you, Bashar, and start to calculate it. CO2.
So firstly, we want to calculate the number of moles. So the number of moles equal the mass of the substance known. Yes, mass of substance divided the molar mass. So firstly, the mass of the substance is 46. The molar mass of the carbon dioxide and the carbon equals 12 plus 2 multiply 16 for the oxygen. It will be 46. Divided by 44, 46 divided by 44, it will be 1.045 watt. We calculate the number of moles, so the mole. If we return back to the scissor, we are going to talk about the carbon dioxide gas. Number of moles. So, find the number of moles. So, firstly, we need the mole in the 46 gram mass. Gram. So, mole in the front of mole is 1. Mole in the front of the mass is the molar mass, the carbon 12, 2 multiplied 16 for the oxygen. I turn back to the problem and find the 46 from the carbon dioxide gas. So, the 46. Cross multiplication, we'll find the problem is a solid. First example.
Talking about the example. Firstly, we'll find the relationship between the number of moles and the mass of the substance.
It's talking about the number of moles and volume. Then, talking about the number of atoms, molecule, ions, and the volume. Then we connect between them and the problem, and we're talking about the chemical calculation according to the chemical equation. Okay. Find,
we deal with each other, that STB, standard temperature, and the pressure.
Find the volume of methane gas of maybe the 0.5 mole of methane gas STB. Hence, we'll find
carbon equal 12, hydrogen equal 1.
If we read a problem, we'll find we need to making a relationship between the number of moles and the volume. So, So, we'll find the mass. In this case, the mass is not related to our calculation, since we're talking about the volume of the substance and the number of moles. So, in this case, we'll find that, like, the mass is not related to the problem. But start to firstly write the rule. For the 1 minute, take per chair and start to calculate this problem. Okay? Then we are going to discuss with you. Firstly, according to the rule, then according to the scissor method. Yes, it's a special number. The letter 22.4. So on each group, think per chair for the 1 minute to solve this problem. Yes? Firstly, if we write the rule, we need to find the volume of the substance. According to this rule, the volume of the substance, we will hide it. The volume of the substance equal the number of moles times 22.84. Volume of substance equal number of moles times 22.4 liter. Return to the problem, where is the number of moles? We'll find the volume of 0.5 mole. So, the number of mole is 0.5 times 22.4, it will be 11.2 liter. According to the method, this method, we'll find sometimes you forget the unit. Okay, time. Return back to the scissor method. We're talking about the methane gas, so the methane gas C4, and we need to calculate the volume of the methane gas, so the volume, and what the unit of the volume, liter, then, 0.5 mole. Change it to the volume from the methane gas, it will be 22.4 liter, okay? Mole in the front of mole is 1. Return to the problem, we'll find 0.5 mole. Cross multiplication, we'll find the problem is a solve. Type. The last type from the problem, according to the simple method. We are going to talk about the number of atoms, molecule, ions, and calculating the number of mole, then we connect between the mass of the substance, maybe the mass of the substance and number of atoms or molecule, the mass of the substance and the volume. Then we are going to talk about the chemical calculation according to the chemical equation, balanced chemical equation. But firstly, what do you want?
What is the number of molecules handled in two moles of maybe sodium chloride? Na equal 23, and we find chlorine equal 35.5.
Firstly, for the 1 minute, think per chair. According to the rule, firstly, according to the normal way, we start to write the rule. We need, what is the number of molecules? The number of molecules, we'll find this section. We're gonna talk about this section. Number of the molecules. Number of molecules is the same number of atoms, number of ions, not a problem in. So we need the number of molecules. It will be the number of moles times 6.02, number of molecules. It will be what? 6.02, our number of moles, times 6.02 times 10 power 23. It will be what? 2 moles, 2 times 6.02 times 10 power 23. Equal 12.04 times 10 power 23 molecules. Easy. Okay, what's making this problem is harder? Yes? 24, it is according to the calculation of problem about it. But if we want to making this problem is more harder, if I told you I want to do the number of moles of atoms, not molecules,
we'll change this word. Individually first, start to think, then think per share, we'll find for this saying it will be 2 minutes, okay?
We want the number of moles of atoms, not molecules.
Number of moles of atoms.
طب ما انا كده لازم اجيب الاتومز الاول عشان اجيب المولز.
If we dissolve the sodium chloride in the water,
NaCl,
dissolve it in water, ماشي؟ And start to calculate the number of moles of ions.
Of
ions. خلينا أقولها number of moles of ions زي لازم ions. What's meant by the كلمة the word ions? Ions it means we dissolve it in the water. Yep. You have 2 minutes. We know that the STEM student is knowing what we want to know. The STEM student does not need a teacher. He's the only teacher.
6.2 can
that ED.
6.2 can that ED.
This is Avogadro's number, it's a fixed number.
كده جبت الغاز خلاص ما كده
هاتي الموز بتاعتها
اجيب ماشي
موز وفاي
طب ثانيه بس استنى شويه امي
استنى بس عشان
مش انا عارفه استنى حلها بقى
still 1 minute
انا عرفتها بس انا
still 20 seconds still. Firstly, we have the sodium chloride. So the sodium chloride is a solid substance. Solid, yes? Sodium chloride is solid. But after we dissolve it in the water, we'll find...
23.
After we dissolve it in the water, we'll find the sodium ions produced and the chlorine ions is produced, aqueous and aqueous. So, we'll find the 2 moles of ions, 2 moles of A ions. So according to this, I want from you to calculate the number of moles of ions, number of moles of A ions. So, since we have a 2 moles from the sodium chloride, 2 multiply Na, it will be 2 Na. 2 multiply Cl, it will be 2 Cl. So, in this, we not determine the sodium, we not determine the chlorine. We said the number of moles of ions for all the problem. So, we'll find the number of moles of ions. In this case, it will be 4 mole of ion. So, according to this equation, we want to calculate the number of moles of ions. So, number of ions. Moles of ions equal 4
we need the number of ions back, in this case, the number of ions, it will be number of ions, number of ions equal. Number of moles, the number of moles in a can? 4. Times Avogadro's number, 6.02 times 10 power 23, equal ions.
Take
it. Firstly, it is the rule to solve this problem. Okay? According to the number of molecules, machine, from this number, maybe the atom, ions, or molecules. But specifically, we'll find the, I told you I want the number of mole of ions from the sodium chloride. Sodium chloride is a substance making the aqueous solution. What's meant by the aqueous solution? Ions dissolve in water. So, when we dissolve the sodium chloride in the water, giving to us one mole from the sodium ion and one mole from chlorine ion. So it brings to us one mole from the sodium chloride, gives to us two mole from, one from the sodium and one from chlorine. If I told you, you have two moles of the sodium chloride, so duplicated, the two moles will give to us four moles of ions. If you want to calculate the number of ions according to the Avogadro's number, number of ions equal number of moles times Avogadro's number. We have, in this case, four moles, you have four multiplied 6.02. But according to the problem, we have
Okay.
In this case, according to the equation, after we enter in the equation changes all the things. It's not related to the simple substance now. It is the substance that is all in the water. So I want from what is the number of mole of ions found in the 2 mole of the sodium chloride according to this equation. We find now in the equation. Equation 2NaCl giving us 2NaFS and 2Cl. So what is the number of mole of ions? Firstly, number of mole of ions according to the equation we have 4 mole of ions. Okay? 4 multiplying the what? Multiply the Avogadro's number. Okay? Now we are going to talk about how to connect between the mass and volume. And how to connect between the mass and number of atoms, volume and number of atoms, number of molecules. Then talking about the chemical equation and the balancing of chemical equation. Find the solve of the problem. Five.
Thank you.
Between the number of moles and ions, and maybe the mass. If you find a problem like this, what is it? The number of molecules found in 20 grams of calcium oxide. Calcium equals 20, oxygen equals 16. CAO. كالسيوم اكسيد سي اي او
تاكد
فإذا كانت المولز دي بقى قلت خليها جرام وحسبها على اساس ان هي جرام. شو هتطلع زي ده؟
يعني هي كانت غلط؟
اه مش مظبوطه جدا.
Thank you.
الترم الاول ما كانش فيه الا هو مليان غير الثالث او الرابع اللي هو كان فيه لاين سبيكتروم والكوانتم ما كانش فيه اللي هو كان فيه لاين سبيكتروم لا ده كان في الاخر
اوكي بس باك فيرستلي وي توكينج اباوت ذا نمبر اوف مولكيولز and the 20 gram. From where I can connect between the number of molecules and that 20 gram? Firstly, number of moles. Number of moles equal mass of the substance divided the molar mass. So the mass of the substance is 20. The molar mass of the calcium oxide, 40 for the calcium, and the 16 for the oxygen. It will be 20 divided 56. It will be what?
It's
wrong to me. Okay, it's wrong to me. We'll find the 40. Okay? Okay, but your calculation is good. It's good. Okay? No problem in your calculation according to the 20. So, it will be calculated now 20 divided 56. We must connect it with the charger. It will be charger is very low. So it will be what?
Zero point three five.
Yes.
Seven.
Okay, maybe 0.36. Okay.
How about this?
Moles. Yes, moles. And the number of moles, number of moles, equal according to the number of molecules, to equal number of molecules, number of molecules, divided 6.02 times 10 power 23. Alhamdulillah. Number of moles in this case, it will be what? It will be 0.36. Number of molecules are unknown, 6.02 times 10 power 23. Cross multiplication will find the number of a molecule. If we calculate it according to the scissor. Scissors make it, the thing is maybe simple. Since we're talking about the calcium oxide, firstly the moon, we read the problem, we'll find the number of molecules, and the 20 gram. 20 gram is the mass in the gram. Then, mole changes the molecule according to calcium oxide, Avogadro's number fixed number 6.02 times 10 bar 23. Mole changes to the mass according to the calcium oxide, it will be the molar mass, the calcium by the 40, oxygen equal 16. Returning back to the problem, in the problem we'll find that 20 gram. Under the mass 20 gram, cross multiplication will find the problem is the solvent. So in this way we'll find the scissor, it makes it easier, okay? More better than the rule, according to the rule. Okay? Type. Another example, but now we connect between the maybe the volume and the number of molecules. What is the volume of? What is the volume of
I've determined the volume of (12.04 × 10^23) molecules of what? Hydrogen chloride. Of hydrochloric
acid.
HCl. HCl, yes. Hydrogen equal 1. This is a light check. Hydrogen equal 1. Chlorine equals 35.5. Individually, same thing per chain with each other. نمشي غير محلها يلا أول مسألة بس سيب أول مسألة خلاص بصوا بقى يا شباب currently we are starting to talk about the scissor hydrogen chloride moment hydrogen chloride the mole want the volume according to molecules so when I change the mole from the hydrogen chloride gas or hydrochloric acid according to the volume it will be a fixed number 22.4 When we change it to molecule, the fixed number is 6.02 × 10^23. If you want to calculate 12.04 × 10^23, what is the result? Cross multiplication. We'll find the maybe 44.8. Yeah.
You can't get it now.